Just 2 years ago, a complete set of RepRap electronics will cost upwards of 200 bucks. Now, this board has all the features and cost me just 40 bucks. Is that too good to be true? I'm Tom, and this is my review of the Geeetech Melzi. Now, the Melzi board is a RepRap control board that was designed to be cheap to manufacture and should enable as many users as possible to take up 3D printing. It's based on the well-known San Gunululino, which itself was already a low-budget board. The Melzi expands on that by including a couple more features like a high-powered fan output and an SD slot. Of course, it also has the basic set of features like 4A4988 based stepper drivers, two more outputs for a hot end and a hot bed, and of course 3 end stop inputs and 2 thermistor inputs. Geeetech aren't the only ones manufacturing this board, but they were by far the cheapest. They sell it for about 40 euros on their eBay store and for about 60 euros in their regular online store. That is about as much as other sources charge you. It came in this pretty large box. It was wrapped in bubble wrap and an anti-static bag, but they still managed to choose a box that is too small for the board. I doubt it would have survived if the box got smashed in any way. The board itself doesn't look too shabby at first sight. I've definitely seen worse. The SMD soldering job on the front is pretty much top notch, but there is some flux residue on the front and on the back as well, which is easy enough to clean up with a bit of alcohol, but it's still a sticky annoyance anyways. The through-hole soldering of the connectors is fairly good as well. There are no dry joints or cold joints, but they managed to smear a bit of solder around this part, which is almost causing a short, but just doesn't. Now, what I did notice were two broken connectors. This one for the C motor is missing a latching tongue that is supposed to keep the connector from falling out. And this one for the hot end is missing another tongue, which should keep your braided wires from fraying when you tighten it down. Again, those two missing pieces aren't a huge deal, but they're another small annoyance. Now, what is going to be a huge annoyance are the types of MOSFETs they choose. These three MOSFETs for the hotbed, the hot end, and the fans are identical ones, and they are about the worst type they could possibly choose. They are ME10N06 types manufactured by Mitsuki. Now, when I'm saying these are bad types, they are so bad that the manufacturers stopped making them. Apparently, they couldn't manage to make them that bad, so all the ones you can buy are two ranks up. These are 60 volt 13 amp types, but because they have such a high DC resistance, you can only load them with up to about 3 amps before they burn up. A heated bed typically draws around 12 or 13 amps, so running one directly from this board is out of the question. I guess you'll be fine with adding a solid state relay, but on the other hand, they could have just used a better MOSFET and made it work the way it was supposed to. The Geeetech guys obviously don't pay much detail to attention, which should be clear by now. So as expected, they copied the flaw where the thermistor inputs have 10K pull-ups. RepRap standard is 4.7K, which gives a better resolution at high temperatures, and also means that the firmware's thermistor tables are interchangeable between different boards. With the 10K resistors in here, you'll either have to compile your own thermistor tables or swap these out for 4.7K ones. Otherwise, you won't get correct readings. Basic functionality is all there though. I tested all three MOSFETs with a 40 watt heater cartridge, and they work well with a small load like that. The stepper drivers are all working nicely too, and they should
even provide a bit more current than the typical pull-up drivers, since the Melzi has more area for cooling them.
In fact, since the bottom of the board doesn't have any obstructions around the drivers, you can just glue a heatsink or an aluminum slab to the bottom of the board and cool it that way. In fact, that is the preferred way to cool them anyways. The pots on the front were initially set to 2 amps, but that isn't a huge deal since you need to tune your drivers to the motors you're using anyways. The drivers use 50 milliohm sense resistors, which is the same value as genuine pull-up boards. The board came with a standard Arduino bootloader installed, so uploading firmware is fairly painless once you figure out that the chip on here isn't actually an Atmega 1284P, which the RepRap wiki points you to, but actually the smaller 644P, which is the same one as in the Sanguinoluino. So to upload firmware, you need to use the Sanguino files and not the one that are provided on the RepRap wiki. One more specialty about the Melzi in general is that it has a green status LED right here that by default does nothing at all. You have to trigger it manually by sending an M42 command to the board. So to turn it on, you send M42S255 without the P for pin. To turn it off, you send M42S0. It's not particularly useful in any way, but hey, it's a feature. So would I recommend this board to others? No. The wrong choice of thermistor pull-ups and the super shooting MOSFET ruined it for me. They make the board unusable for anyone who isn't an expert user, and the last thing we need is another brick in the road when it comes to building a 3D printer. Would I personally buy it again? Probably. Swapping in proper pull-ups is a quick job when you have the right tools at hand, and even the MOSFETs aren't bothering me much. I'll be expanding the board for dual extruders, and so I'll just be using the onboard FETs for the hot ends and power the bed through an external beefier MOSFET. But then again, if you know what you're doing, you can fix about anything. Geeetech really could have done a better job with this board at minimum effort. So that concludes my first RepRap video. If you like what I'm doing, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. I have a lot of subjects lined up, so please let me know in the comments what you'd like to see next. I'm Tom, thanks for watching.